Hello students, my name is Debbie Fernandez and I am from Poddar International School, Hoffnagar. Today, I will be teaching you the chapter Acid, Base and Salt. The learning objectives of today's topic are, you will understand what is an acid, you will also understand the types of acid, and the third thing that you are going to understand are the properties of acid. So let's start. Now, if you see most of the things around you, there are a wide variety of substances. Every substance differs in their taste, smell and color. I will now show few substances to you. Let's try and find out and distinguish them based on their taste. The first substance is a lemon. The taste of a lemon is sour. The second substance in my hand is baking powder. The taste of baking powder is bitter. I also have a salt solution which I prepared by adding few crystals of sodium chloride, that is NaCl, in water. The taste of this is salty. Our tongue is a sense organ which helps us to distinguish a variety of tastes. If we have to classify substances based on the taste, it's not a proper method. Substances should be classified based on their properties. Based on properties, these substances are classified into three types. The first type is acid. The second type is base. And the third type is salt. So substances are basically classified into three types based on their properties: acids, base and salt. In today's lecture, we are specifically going to understand about acids. So when I showed you a lemon, I said that the taste is sour. Let's take some few more examples. If you take tamarind, if you take amla, curds, even lemon, all these have one thing in common, that is a sour taste. Substances like lemon, curds, tamarind, amla are sour because they have a chemical which is called acid. Acids are present all around in a number of things. Acids are available in the chemical laboratories. Acids are produced in plants. Acids are also obtained and produced in animals. Now, few examples would be nitric acid, citric acid, tartaric acid, etc. Do you know there is one acid that is also present in a human body? The stomach contains hydrochloric acid, which helps in the digestion of the food. Now, acids are also classified into two types. The first type of acid is natural acid, and the second type is mineral acid. As the name suggests, natural acids are natural. They are produced by plants, they are produced by animals, and they are also known as organic acids. Citric acid, tartaric acid, lactic acid are few examples of natural acids. Talking about mineral acids, they are produced by inorganic compounds and so they are also known as inorganic acids. The examples are, this is hydrochloric acid, this is an example of mineral acid. This is a bottle of nitric acid. This also is an example of inorganic or mineral acid. Now let's understand the properties of acid. I have written four properties of acid. Let's understand one by one each property. The first property is quite simple. When I showed you the lemon and when I defined acid also, we were quite clear about the taste. Acids have a sour taste. If you name any acid, be it lemon, tamarind, amla, they have one thing in common, and that one thing in common is the sour taste, because that is the first property of acid, that is acids have a sour taste. Coming to the second property, acids dissolve in water. Let's try it out. I have a test tube. This test tube is filled with dilute acetic acid. I have another test tube. This is filled with normal water. I will now add few drops of acetic acid in water. Let's see if it's able to dissolve in it or not. So, I have added few drops of acetic acid, and as you can see, it has completely dissolved. It has been dissolved in the solution. The solution is a clear solution, because that is the second property of acid, that is acids are able to dissolve in water. Let's go to the third property. The third property says that acids are corrosive. Now, what is the meaning of corrosive? Corrosive specifically means it dissolves the surface. It can dissolve the surface of a metal. It can dissolve the surface of living tissue. Even cloth and wood, the surface can be dissolved. This property is called corrosive property, and acids are corrosive in nature. If you check out the bottle of acetic acid, you would definitely find this symbol. This is the symbol which shows the liquid inside the bottle is corrosive. If you see any other bottles of acid, you will definitely find the similar type of a warning. Here also, there is a warning sign which shows the liquid inside this bottle is corrosive in nature. Coming to the last property of acid, acids can be strong or weak. Now, when I explained the second property, I said that acids dissolve in water. When acids dissolve in water, the H plus ions get dissociated. If the H plus ion is dissociated completely, we call it a strong acid. Few examples are nitric acid, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid is also another example of a strong acid. Similarly, when an acid is dissolved in water and the H plus ion is dissociated but not completely, partially, at that time we call an acid a weak acid. Acetic acid, citric acid, tartaric acid are few examples of weak acids. So, thank you so much.